Let's say we have the simplest of arithmetic sequences and probably the simplest of sequences. So 1, 2, we're going to start at 1 and just increment by 1. 1, 2, 3, and we're going to go all the way to n. And what I want to think about is, what is the sum of this sequence going to be? And the sum of a sequence, we already know, we call a series. So what is the sum, and I'll just call it s sub n, what is this going to be equal to? 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus going all the way to n. Well, we're going to do a neat little trick here where I'm going to rewrite this sum. So I'll write it again as s sub n. But now I'm just going to write it in reverse order. I'm going to write it as n plus n minus 1 plus n minus 2 all the way to 1. And now I'm going to add these two equations. So we know that s sub n is equal to this, so we're adding the same thing to both sides of this equation up here. So on the left-hand side, you're going to have s sub n plus s sub n is just 2 times s sub n. And on the right-hand side, and this is where we start to see something kind of cool, you have a 1 plus an n, which is just going to be n plus 1. You have a 2 plus n minus 1, which is, well, 2 plus n minus 1 is going to be n plus 1 again, plus n plus 1. You have a 3 plus n minus 2. Well, that's going to be n plus 1 again. N plus 1, I think you see what is going on here. And you're going to go all the way to this last pair, I guess you could say it, or call it these last two terms. And we have an n plus 1 again, plus n plus 1. So how many of these n plus 1s do we have? Well, we have n of them. There were n of these terms in each of these equations. 1, 2, 3, all the way to n. So we can rewrite this thing as 2 times s sub n is equal to, you have n plus 1 terms. So we could write it as n times n plus 1. N times n plus 1. And now to solve for s sub n, to solve for our sum, we can just divide both sides. We can just divide both sides by 2. And so we are going to be left with the sum from 1 to n, this arithmetic sequence where we're just incrementing by 1, starting at 1, is going to be equal to n times n plus 1 over 2. And this is neat because now you can quickly find the sum, let's say, from 1 to 100. It'll be 100 times 101 over 2. So very quickly you can find these sums. And what I'm curious about and what we'll explore in the next video is, can we generalize this for any arithmetic sequence? We started with a very simple one. We started at 1, we just incremented by 1. And it looks like this is, so if I were to write it this way, this is n times n plus 1 over 2. So this right over here, this n, this is the nth term in our sequence. And this right over here, this 1, was the first term in our sequence. So at least in this case, it looks like I took the average of the first term and the nth term. So this right over here, let me make it clear. This is the average. Actually, we do it like this. This right over here is the average of our a sub 1 and a sub n. And then I'm multiplying that times n. And what I'm curious about is whether this is going to be true for any arithmetic sequence, that the sum of it is going to be the average of the first and the last term times the number of terms.